Hi friends, I am Samad. I am here again to discuss with some more topics. So this is my second videos, okay? And I am going to upload more and more videos, which is very important for our competitive exam, which is like GATE, DRDO exam, ATPL, some piloting courses, exams. So we are going to upload more videos. So please keep subscribe and watch all videos one by one. I am going to make a playlist, so go for playlist and see all videos, okay? So there I uploaded many videos for GATE exams and designing courses, okay? So if you want to know, if you want to see that videos, so go to my YouTube channel, C and Guru YouTube channels, and you can see all videos, which is very very important for your entrance exam. So this, in this video, I will discuss with some questions about basics. So let's start. So here is the first question, okay? Assuming no flow separation and no compressibility effects, there is given no flow separation, okay, and no compressibility effects. The location of center of pressure of a symmetrical airfoil section. So what is symmetrical airfoil? This is the symmetrical airfoil. Both parts means upper and lower parts are equal, okay? So this is the symmetrical airfoil, okay? And what is center of pressure? Center of pressure is the point at which all the forces acting on it, okay? So there are forces, drag forces, lift forces, which is generated by airfoils. So that all forces acting on that points, which is called center of pressure. So here is given the location of center of pressure for symmetrical airfoil, okay? So what is the option? So we have the is at approximately 25% chord irrespective of the angle of attack. So for that, D is the right option, okay? It is around 25% chord, okay, respective of the angle of attack, okay? So here actually this is the 25% from leading edge, okay? So we can say here is the center of pressure, okay? Now we will see the second question. Assuming no flow separation and no compressibility effect, the location of center of pressure is symmetrical, same questions, but this is the different option. They are different option, okay? So which is actually this is independent of angle of attack, okay? So in most of the symmetrical airfoil, which is symmetrical airfoil, okay, so little changes of angle of attack will not change the center of pressure. So that's how we can say that this is independent of angle of attack, okay? So is the right option. Now we will see the second next questions. Next question is the lift coefficient CL versus angle of attack curve of a symmetrical airfoil. Again, here is given symmetrical airfoil section intersects the horizontal axis of the graph. Okay, so how can we solve this question? So first of all, we have to know that what is the graph of this. We have lift coefficient, okay, and angle of attack, which is denoted by alpha, okay, and this is given intersects the horizontal axis of the graph, okay? So actually this is given symmetrical airfoil. The symmetrical airfoil graph is comes from the origin, okay? So we have the third is the right option at the origin, okay? And this is the negative camber airfoil, this is the positive camber airfoil, this is the graph actually, okay? On lift coefficient and angle of attack. So this is for symmetrical airfoil. Okay. Now the next question is the lift coefficient versus angle of attack curve of negative camber airfoil. I show you this is the negative camber airfoil. Okay. So intersects the horizontal axis of the graph. So horizontal, this is the horizontal axis of the graph. So we can say that to the right of the origin. So A is the right, this is the right side, and this is the left side. So to the right side of the origin, Okay, so A is the right option. Now we will see the next questions. Next question is, assuming all bodies have the same cross sectional area and are in the motion, which body will have the highest pressure drag? So he has given four. Figure is given, okay. So which one has the highest pressure drag? So we have body 2. Body 2 has the highest pressure drag because pressure drag depends on velocity, okay. Means higher the velocity, higher the pressure drag. And it depends on frontal area, that is greater the frontal area, okay, greater will be the pressure drag. So you can see this is the greater frontal area, okay. This is also the same frontal area. So let's see the next principle. So I'm going to write here, okay, pressure drag depends on velocity, okay, means higher the velocity, higher the pressure drag. Second is frontal area. Okay, this is the frontal area. Okay, and the surface roughness. Surface roughness means higher the roughness means more roughness means more pressure drag. So, roughness. Okay, this also depends on surface roughness. And the shape of the object means more rounded the shape, lower pressure drag, okay. So this is also the depends on shape of the objects, okay. So here you can see that higher velocity, higher drag, higher frontal area, higher drag, higher surface roughness, more surface roughness, more drag, but more rounded, more rounded, okay. I'm going to write rounded will decrease the pressure drag. So more rounded the shape, lower the pressure drag. So in all four figure, if you see, so here this is the, okay, if you see this part, okay, this is only the rectangular part like that. So this is the, this is very less rounded, okay, this is not a rounded body. So that's why it has, this is the means less rounded means higher drag. For that, body 2 is the has highest pressure drag. Now we will see the next question regarding a symmetrical airfoil. Which statements are correct or incorrect? So you can see the angle of attack is 0 when the lift coefficient is equal to 0. So here you can say that which is the angle of attack is 0. If lift coefficient is equal to 0, okay, if lift coefficient is equal to 0, we can say that angle of attack might not be a 0, okay. It has some, because this, there is a camber airfoil. Actually this is given symmetrical airfoil, okay. So the angle of attack is 0 when the lift coefficient is equal to 0. The first is correct, okay, because this is given symmetrical airfoil. And the pitching moment is 0 when the lift coefficient is 0. The second is also correct. So these two statements is, if you, these two statements, okay, is correct for symmetrical airfoil only. So for that we can say that C is the right option, okay. Pitching moment is 0 when the lift coefficient is 0. Now we will see the next question, okay. We will see the next question, okay. Next question is regarding a positively cambered airfoil, which statements are correct or incorrect? So the angle of attack has a positive value when the lift coefficient is equal to 0. Here we have to know that there is the given positively cambered airfoil, okay, not symmetrical airfoil. So according to this, we have to know that the whether this statement, these two statements is correct or incorrect. So first statement is incorrect, okay. So if the angle of attack is positive value, then the lift coefficient has some lift coefficient. So but he has given lift coefficient is equal to 0, so lift coefficient must be exist. So according to this, this is incorrect, okay. And a nose down pitching moment exists when the lift coefficient is 0. Yes, if lift coefficient zero, doesn't matter, but nose down pitching moment will exist. So we have the A is the right option. Okay, first is incorrect and second is correct, because cambered your foil means which have the upper value, upper surface is less compared to the lower value. Okay, lower value surface is higher than the upper value. Okay, so that's why for that this is the asymmetrical airfoil, we can say that nose down pitching moment will exist. Okay, next question is regarding a symmetrical airfoil, which statements are correct or incorrect? The angle of attack has a positive value when the lift coefficient is equal to zero, or the nose down pitching moment exists when the lift coefficient is equal to zero. This is given. Again, you have to see that the question, you have to carefully, you have to read question. Here is given symmetrical airfoil. Okay, so for symmetrical airfoil, we have both are incorrect. Okay, the angle of attack has a positive value when the lift coefficient is zero, so this is incorrect, and the nose down pitching moment will not exist when the lift coefficient is equal to zero. So both are incorrect. Now we will see next question. Next question is regarding a symmetrical airfoil, which statements are correct or incorrect? The angle of attack has a negative value when the lift coefficient is equal to zero. Again, you have to see that first symmetrical airfoil is given. So first is incorrect. A nose up pitching moment exists when the lift coefficient is equal to zero. And second is also the incorrect. So B is the right option. Okay, now we'll see the 10 question. Question number 10, which statement is correct? Stall speeds are determined with the center of gravity of the forward limit, or minimum control speeds are determined with the center of gravity at the forward limit. So first of all, we have to know that what is the stall speed. A stall speed is the minimum speed at which an aeroplane can generate sufficient lift to support its weight. Okay, and angle of attack should be less than a stalling angle of attack. Okay, so this is the definition of a stall speed. Okay, so now we are going to write the factors that affect the stall speed. Okay, so we have to remember some factors, that is V stall is equal to under root 2W into N divided by rho S into CL maximum. When lift coefficient becomes maximum, then you will get the stalling speed, stalling velocity. Okay, so N is the load factor. Okay, so you can see that stalling velocity is equal to square root of weight, and if you see that this is the indirectly proportional density, surface area and maximum lift coefficient. So this formula you have to remember, that a stalling speed increases as the center of gravity moves forward. Okay, so if center of gravity moves forward this side, then the stalling speed will increase. Okay, and the above the 10,000 feet stalling speed slightly increasing. Okay, and this is about the stalling speed. Now we will say that stalling speed are determined with the center of gravity at the forward limit. It is correct or incorrect? So we can say that this is correct. Okay, stall speed are determined with the center of gravity at the forward limit. Now we will see the minimum control speed. What is minimum control speed? Minimum control speed is the speed, actually it is used when the engine fails. Okay, and it is used, minimum control speed, to use the directional control. Okay, to use for directional control, you can maintain the you can maintain using this speed to control the directional. Okay, directions. So here is also the factors of minimum control surface. Factor is that minimum control velocity, sorry, minimum control velocity or speed, okay, decrease if thrust available decrease. minimum control speeds decrease when altitude increasing, okay, and minimum control speeds decrease with forward movement of the center of gravity, with forward movement of the center of gravity, okay. So minimum control speeds are determined with the center of gravity at the forward limit. So it is actually decreasing at the forward limit, okay, with forward limit. So it must be aft limit, okay. So for that, second is the incorrect. First is correct and second is incorrect. So option A is the right option, okay. You can say that. So they are the factor for minimum control surface and stall speeds. If you understand these points, then you can easily get the right option, okay. So because I am just telling you the center of gravity at the forward limit is given, but at the center, if center of gravity moves to forward, then the minimum control speed will decrease. For that's why you cannot determine the minimum control speed with the forward limit, okay. So that's why second is the wrong option, wrong statements, okay. So that's all for 10 questions I explain in these videos, and there are many questions I will show you in the next videos. Bye bye.